So my dear student, today we are going to discuss IUPAC rules of IUPAC nomenclature. Clear? Nomenclature, this word, this nomenclature means process of naming of organic compounds. Organic compounds ka naam likhne ka tarika, process is called nomenclature. So today we are going to discuss this IUPAC rule. What is IUPAC? So before coming to IUPAC, listen carefully. Before 19th century, there were very few organic compounds, means, or in other word we can say, now chemistry has three parts. Chemistry, this chemistry subject is classified, divided into three different branches. First is your inorganic chemistry, another is your organic chemistry and physical chemistry. So basically this chemistry, this subject has three main branches, inorganic, organic and physical. Clear? Now we are now going to discuss this organic part is somewhat difficult, but very interesting it is. If you are knowing the rules, it will become very interesting and marked scoring subject it is. So see, before 19th century se pahle, this branch of chemistry, means organic chemistry, were not very much developed. Ye branch kaafi developed nahi tha. Only few compounds, less number of compounds that can be counted on hand were known. 19th century se pehle kaafi organic compound jo hai kaafi kam sankhya mein maloom tha, theek hai, uski jankari kaafi kam thi. So that time there were no rule of naming which compounds, theek hai. That time before 19th century, what was the rule? Rule was that organic compounds were named after the name of source from which they were obtained. मतलब क्या हुआ कि organic compound का नाम 19th century से पहले organic compound का नाम उसके source के नाम पर दिया जाता था, जिस source से वो प्राप्त किया जाता, जिस the source from which it is obtained. For example, see one example, formic acid. This is an organic acid. Its name, formula is, chemical formula, HCOOH. Clear? Formula we will discuss later on. So formic acid is an organic acid, and this acid is obtained from red ant, lal chiti. So it is obtained from red ant. Clear? Therefore, red ant is known as formica. Red ant is called formica. So, source of this acid is formica, red ant. Therefore, this acid were named formic acid. Is acid ka naam kya pad gaya? Formic acid. क्योंकि वो किससे मिला? फॉर्मिका से, बीच में रेड है. लाल चींटी जिस बॉडी पार्ट पे आप वो काटे वहां पर जलन होता है, बिकॉज दे इंजेक्ट फॉर्मिक एसिड इन योर बॉडी. क्लियर? सो मेन सोर्स ऑफ फॉर्मिक एसिड इज रेड एंड, विच इज कॉल्ड फॉर्मिका, लैटिन वर्ड इट इज. दिस फॉर्मिका इट इज लैटिन वर्ड. सो इन लैटिन फॉर्मिका मीन्स रेड एंड. So from radiant it is obtained, means source is the radiant. Therefore this name, this acid has got its name from the source, formic acid. ये था rule. Another example, acetic acid, very common example. Acetic acid, very common organic acid. Its formula is CH3 and COOH. How to write the formula we will come later on. First see, before 19th century what were the rule of naming the compound? So acetic acid is found from acetum. It is obtained from acetum, and acetum, this is also Latin word and it means vinegar. Every one of you are knowing vinegar. It is a तो वेनेगर वेनेगर इज कॉल्ड एसिटा. तो चूंकि ये एसिड एसिटिक एसिड वेनेगर से निकाला जाता है, वेनेगर से एक्सट्रैक्ट होता है, देयरफॉर दिस एसिड गॉट इट्स नेम फ्रॉम द सोर्स एसिटम, और इसका नाम पड़ गया एसिटिक एसिड. ठीक है, तो बिफोर 19th सेंचुरी वन व्हेन दिस ब्रांच वाज नॉट वेरी मच डेवलप, दीज वेयर द रूल मींस ऑर्गेनिक नेम ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स वेयर गिवन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द नेम ऑफ द सोर्स फ्रॉम व्हिच दे वेयर ऑब्टेन. इन सम केसेस व्हाट हैपेंड, इन सम केसेस द सेम कंपाउंड वेयर गिवन मोर देन वन नेम, लाइक दिस मीथेन. टुडे एवरीवन वी आर नोइंग मीथेन फार्मूला इज CH4, क्लियर, बट दिस मीथेन इज ऑल्सो नोन एज डैम्पफायर, एंड अनदर नेम ऑफ मीथेन इज मार्स गैस. सो सेम कंपाउंड हैज गॉट मोर देन वन नेम. इन सम केसेस व्हाट हैपेंड, सेम कंपाउंड्स वेयर गिवन मोर देन वन नेम. In some part of the world, this methane were known as damphire. At the same time, in other part of the world where chemistry is studied, it is known as Mars gas. And some part of the world where it is popularly known as methane. So in this way, it created a confusion. Confusion बढ़ गया. Study जो है, study of chemistry where not easy then. Because with the progress of time, समय बीतने के साथ, with the passage of time, organic chemistry, this branch of organic chemistry, it became very vast. Many studies occur, many research occur, and a large number of compounds were known, were studied. And nowadays, after we can say toward the end of the 19th century, very very large number of compounds were discovered, organic compounds. तो अब ये possible नहीं रहा कि सभी का इस तरह का नाम को याद रखा जाए. These type of names were called common name. Means there is no rule for common names. Simple one rule were there that the name of an organic compound should be on the basis of the name of the source from which it is obtained. किसी भी organic compound का नाम दे दो जिस source से उसको मिला, उस source के नाम पर. So these were not universally accepted. ये जो नाम्स है ये universally accepted नहीं है. जहाँ जहाँ science का chemistry की पढ़ाई होती है, ये सारा नाम जो है common name, इसको याद करना अब पॉसिबल नहीं रहा, क्योंकि बहुत सारा कंपाउंड अब डिस्कवर हो चुका था. ठीक है,